Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest has the gift of music that will soothe your soul. She's a classically trained violinist who has performed for the Pope and for the Obamas at the White House.
And now she's here to perform for us. Please take a listen to violinist Dr. Melanie Hill performing a song she composed called Boldness.
Hello.
Be careful.
Thank you.
Wow.
Yes. Oh, nice to see you.
That was amazing. Have a seat. And look, and you don't have shoes on, so you do not perform with shoes.
I don't blame you, child.
I do not perform with shoes ever since I can remember.
Really?
It actually comes from scripture, from Exodus 3 and 5. When God tells Moses to take off your sandals because you are standing on holy ground.
Wow.
And, oh my gosh, it's fine.
This is a safe space.
Yes. But it's always sort of a sign of reverence
for me. Amen.
When I take off my shoes because I'm playing for God.
Wow.
And I'm playing for the Lord, and I'm playing for an audience of one. So wherever God takes my feet, I take off my shoes because I'm playing for Him.
Wow.
Oh my God. This is ridiculous because when I'm on stage, right, like, 10 minutes in, my feet be hurt.
Yeah.
It makes my feet hurt because I can take my shoes off. I take my shoes off every show, and I don't record with shoes on.
Wow.
Yes. Deep.
So this is it. You found your reason. This is great.
I'm stealing it.
Right. So Dr. Hill, tell us a little bit about, you know, 4 years old, you knew that you had this musical gift. Take us back then.
Yes. So I started when I was 4 years old playing the violin, and I noticed my older sister, Crystal, play the violin. She's about 10 years older than I am. And I saw her and I said, you know what? I told my mom, I said, I want to do that. I want to learn how to play. And at first my mom thought that I was, you know, too young because I was 4 at the time, but my violin teacher at the time said, she's never too young, start her now.
Mm-hmm.
And I was captivated by the instrument because I feel as though the violin has a beautiful voice.
Yes.
And I feel that the world needs to hear the different iterations of the violin voice, you know, in hip hop, in gospel music, right, in classical music, in jazz, that there are different ways that, you know, that the instrument has its own sort of performative voice.
Yes.
And so I was captivated by the instrument at 4, and I started playing gospel music when I was 10 years old.
Yes.
And I started reading notes. Like I was classically trained, but then I realized when I was 10 that I could play by ear.
Mm.
And I noticed that I put in a Whitney Houston tape. I think it was from The Preacher's Wife.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, well, you know, let me just see if I can play by ear. So I put the tape in, and I turned it off, and then I realized that I could play every note that I heard.
Oh, wow. That's a real gift.
Yeah.
That's a real gift.
Now, when you speak of gospel music and different genres and playing the violin, and you're right, I love the voice of the violin. The strings are just amazing.
Yeah.
So when you play the violin, what do you feel, since you have gospel roots, what do you feel the most, though? Because you can play all genres.
Yeah.
So which one kind of speaks to your spirit other than gospel?
Other
because
than
we
gospel,
know that's
going
to be the home base.
Absolutely. I feel that also jazz as well. Speaks to the spirit, and it's this spirit of improvisation that you're playing from your heart and your soul, right?
Yes.
So when we think of the violin, we think of classical music, right? But now that we're entering into the 21st century, right, we're seeing all of these different sort of ways in which the violin can have a primary voice, right, in music. And so you have artists like Sister Rosetta Tharpe, right, who played her guitar. She was a gospel blues guitarist as well. And so I'm just so grateful.
Good.
Yes.
Really quickly, I mean, of course, you played for the Obamas, Pope Francis, and now you're going to be a part of Alice Walker's 75th birthday.
That is
how
true.
Does that make you feel?
Yes, I am truly honored, and I'm grateful that Dr. Alice Walker would have me play and perform during the Words and Music segment on Saturday, July 13th. And I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be in Atlanta, and it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful time.
Yes. This spirit right here.
It's
so yummy.
It makes you smiles and make you want to smile.
Right, exactly. Thank you so much, Dr.
Thank
Hill, for being
so
here.
Thank you so much.
For more information, come on, Rashawn. For more information on this amazing woman, you can actually follow her on Instagram at Dr. Melanie Violin 1.